Hello everyone, and welcome back to My GM and WWE 2K22. Last time, we were able to fulfill Tamina's request for a pay-per-view match. She even managed to pick up the victory, and that's a major increase to her morale. I've been talking with Bailey a lot lately, and she had this great idea we should team up for a tag match. Alright, sure, we'll do that. We gave Asuka her heel turn, and now she wants to team up with Bailey, which is certainly an interesting development. Nakamura's contract expires this week. Schedule a run-in. Alright. Well, we're certainly not going to have it be on Nakamura. Our main event tonight. Title on the line. Champ always comes out last. Kevin Owens. And Shinsuke Nakamura. WWE title on the line. Can KO take it? Can he take the gold from Shinsuke Nakamura? We have to hope. Really have to hope that we can do it, that we can pull it off. So we got more crew. We got, oh no, the veteran lights was the one that we just unlocked. Okay. So I think then, since Steve Austin is back, we're gonna have him cut a self promo and hype himself up, because he could potentially, you know, provided that we still have a championship for him to challenge for, maybe, just maybe, teaming up with Kevin Owens was his way to get a foot in the door and go after KO. Well, let's see. That could be an exciting program for sure. So let's see. We've got a level 3 rivalry between Bailey and Ember Moon that's still ongoing. Oh, we still haven't done Rhea Ripley versus Shayna Baszler, which, yes, I realized in the last recording I was pronouncing her name wrong the whole time. And I feel stupid for it, but it's okay. It's okay. I've looked up some of her matches, so I actually, like, you know, have the Rhea Ripley. It's fine. It's not the first time I've mispronounced a name. Probably won't be the last, but we are opening the show with Rhea Ripley and Shayna Baszler one-on-one. That's going to be big. And then I guess, mid-card, what do we want to do here? So, we do have Mickie James and Peyton Royce. That's a new rivalry. I want to get Keith Lee on the show. We haven't done anything with Keith Lee since his first week. We can bring back the team of Cesaro and Keith Lee. That'll be our first play. And we'll have it be, how do we want to do this? So Cesaro and Keith Lee, that's a giant and a bruiser. Maybe what we could do. Let's have it be, do we want it to be Morrison though? Not so sure. Maybe not Cesaro. Maybe we'll give Cesaro a break. Let's actually do the team of Jeff Hardy and Keith Lee. No. Because, I mean, the rivalry with Murphy just ended, so maybe we don't quite want that. Triton. We haven't had Triton on the show either in a while. No, we'll go ahead and have Cesaro on the show with Keith Lee. Make the tag team match. I feel like Murphy should be in there somewhere, because Murphy's coming off a feud. And I guess Balor doesn't have anything going on this week because KO is busy. So let's do Balor and Murphy. No, Finn's been in like a weird like revolving door of tag teams. So maybe not that. We never took a look at free agency. What's going on in free agency this week? We have Bobby Lashley, Dolph Ziggler, we got Seth Rollins. If we wanted to get a permanent contract, we could go for Lashley or Ziggler. As if we need more superstars on our roster, I know. That's probably why my budget is decently lower, between like upgrades and signing all these superstars. Trent 7. I'm overthinking it. We do not need to sign a free agent this week. Ah, man, because if I have two singles matches, it's like I just have too many people on my roster. Just simply too many people. Once again, maybe I was overthinking it. What we have here, we have Cesaro, who lost his big match with John Morrison. We have Murphy, who lost the big match with Jeff Hardy. And we have Finn Balor, who lost the tag team match. So, really, except for Keith Lee, you know, this match composed of guys who looking to get a win back after their big pay-per-view defeats. So that is what we are gonna attempt to do tonight. We can go ahead and book it in the Capitol Wrestling Center because we have a level 2 rivalry. We don't have any of the optional goals here, unfortunately. We can go for... You know what? Let's go ahead and purchase the veteran light effects for just everything. Just go for everything. This is... Why would we need to earn money? Let's just throw it all back into the show. I mean, in like the logistics, you earn it back, pretty much, so... Book one special match type, run-in, or GM interference. Oh, that's right. I need to have a run-in, don't I? Okay, then can we do a run-in in a tag team match? We can. Let's see. How would we want to do this? Because we just had some rivalries end here. We don't want to have John Morrison go after Cesaro, because that wouldn't really work. And it would make sense to have a heel get involved. So we could have John Morrison start a feud with Keith Lee, maybe? Or Jeff Hardy could go out after Finn Balor, but that doesn't quite seem right. I don't know. I'll have Morrison go after Keith Lee. That'll get our commissioner goal. Hopefully that doesn't drag the rating down, because like Morrison's not going after Cesaro, he's going after Cesaro's partner. And that makes all the difference in the world. So that's our commissioner goal. We're not getting Asuka's tag match quite yet, but we will. We will. Were there any other things, any other promises we made? Not on the list here. So yeah, we got Rhea Ripley and Shayna Baszler. Or maybe we don't even need to do that match right away. We have the title match. Because like I could do the... I'm overthinking it. I've already booked the show. We're sticking with it. This is the show. We're doing it. And I'm trying to like figure out what a good balance is of like simulation and actually playing the matches, because I did a couple episodes where I played all the matches, you know, kind of get a feel for that style of commentary again for calling a match. And I don't know, I think I'm still kind of getting back into the groove, but you know, I also want to get through this GM mode kind of quick. So we're going to simulate this week's show. Who gets the win? Shayna Baszler knocks off Rhea Ripley. In a two-star match? Really? It's a level 2 rivalry, and it's a two-star match? Garbage. This game hates me. Only a good promo by Stone Cold, which is unfortunate. Tag match Cesaro and Keith Lee against Murphy and Finn Balor. And the win goes to Balor and Murphy off the distraction from John Morrison. Bianca Belair, charity promo. We're gonna get crushed this week. Okay, this is the moment of truth. Can Kevin Owens... take the title? You know, maybe I should spectate this one. I don't know. Maybe things have been... We're gonna leave it to chance. KO, please get the title. Yeah, he did it. Watch it be like disqualification or something. That would be awful. So KO wins the title back in a 3.5-star. Nakamura gone from the show. And as long as it wasn't a disqualification, he will not take the title with him. Why are they putting the title on the line in the mid-card? Surely this is like a booking no-no. How is that right? Why are they still doing this? I'm in purgatory. Braun Strowman and Ricochet will never end. It will just happen every show. They're doing Brock and Tyler Breeze again. Do you have no other rivalries on your card? I swear. Tyler Breeze retains the title. Match gets 3-star. They're doing it again. Breeze and Lesnar. I can't. How are they killing us in the ratings? This doesn't make any sense. They've been doing the same matches over and over and over and over and over again. The rivalry ends. They just do it again. And... But of course they have better booking than us. Because that's how that works. Just don't reinvent the wheel. Just same things over and over again. Let's make sure that this didn't end in a DQ. All right, Owens won it for real. So Nakamura, the title is gone. Or I mean, the title is out of his grasp. We have our title back. And Nakamura is gonna go to free agency. Good fit of classes. Wait, Owens Mania at SmackDown. Wonder how long that will last. I mean, Owens is on quite the winning streak. Stone Cold Steve Austin doing good work on the mic tonight, kept the audience entertained. Not sure the better superstar won tonight, so Rhea Ripley looking for a rematch against Shayna Baszler. We'll get that at some point. Owens wins the championship. Owens deserves it. This is true. This is true. Finn Balor also seemed to destroy Cesaro tonight. Lee and Cesaro have absolutely no chemistry as a tag team, but I swear I was told before that they had chemistry. I don't understand. Every match in this week's SmackDown felt different from the last one, and yet we lost the ratings. And yet we still lost. We got free advertising booking, but it's not enough. We are in trouble. We are not doing good. You could have told me that we didn't gain any fans from that show, and I would believe you, because I can't tell if that number has gone up or not. Maybe it has, and it's just the 53,000 part that's throwing me. Oh, we're not doing good. We're not doing good. 3 weeks until Extreme Rules. Yep, Keith Lee wants to settle things with John Morrison. We're absolutely going to give him that opportunity. Small increase. Johnny Drip Drip is here. I've been putting in a lot of work, and I think I've earned a shot at the title. America's Moist Wanted? What are these? What are these? What are these? I mean, Morrison did beat Cesaro in the end to the feud. And I think his... Owens is a bruiser, Morrison's a fighter, so I think we could do that. We need to prove that Kevin Owens is a fighting champion anyway. Yeah, so... Okay, we managed to keep the title, which is good. Nakamura is no more. The thorn in our side is gone. And, what is Owens' record? He's 6-3, he's won 4 in a row, which is pretty good. Cesaro, on the other hand, the exact opposite, which is not good. Morrison is 4-3, Balor's 3-5, Jeff Hardy 4-2, Baszler's 4-2, Bianca 4-4. Oh, I don't know why I had to check Rhea Ripley. Murphy 3-5. So this is just, I don't know, interesting to look at the records and see how everybody's doing. Tamina 1-7, so she got that win. Can maybe, this could be the start of something big for her. So this week we're going to go ahead and put Asuka and Bayley together in that tag team match. We're going to put them up against Ember Moon and Toni Storm, because Ember and Toni, they've proven that they can be a functional tag team together. And as well, you know, Ember still in that feud with Bayley, but also the important thing is that Ember Moon and Toni Storm are on quite the winning streak. Like, I know Bianca is the one we're trying to build up for a future opportunity at the title. Bianca was even the one that Asuka name dropped when she mentioned wanting to turn heel. However, Ember Moon at 6-3, that's a very impressive record. Toni Storm 5-2, also, you know, racking up a lot of wins and rivalries. So really, we're getting together like a lot of our women who have very good records have shown that they can perform at a top level. So we're putting them all in the ring at the same time, and we're going to hope for the best. And just to make sure that this doesn't bomb as an opener, because apparently I don't know how to book, we're going to go ahead and make this a tables match. Tables tag team match. Ember Moon, Toni Storm, Bayley, Asuka. That's what we're going to do. I think we're also going to have... We want to do some sort of call-out promo. I think let's keep trying to build with Mickie and Peyton. So we'll have this time Mickie James is going to come down to the ring and call out Peyton Royce on the mic, and hopefully that'll go okay. Of course, in the mid-card, we're going to give Keith Lee that match against John Morrison, so we're just going to go ahead, take care of our promises, you know, right away. Not so much for John Morrison, but if Morrison beats Keith Lee, then that'll make it more convincing when we put him in a title match against Kevin Owens. And Owens has really been a workhorse. I think we can probably give him the week off, maybe, or put him in a promo or something. I mean, look at that, 4 wins in a row, 6-3. Owens is just on an absolute tear. Absolute tear through the roster. So we gotta figure out what our main event is gonna be. You know, we do have that rivalry with Finn Balor, which kind of still needs a payoff. We could do a rematch with Shayna Baszler and Rhea Ripley just in like a, just an absolute, just a brawl, just an absolute slugfest, Extreme Rules sort of affair. I don't know. Our commissioner goal is to not put Stone Cold Steve Austin in a match this week, which is probably good. I don't think he really needs that. We'll actually put him in a charity promo, because I'd have to imagine that that's going to go well, and we're going to get some fans off of that. it's, you know, we're using him even if he's not in a match, you know. I mean, you bring back the legend, you want to try to, you know, keep bring in those fans and really have, you know, really maximize the effect of that one. Maximize the effect of the contract stuff, legend, star power, words. Main event, maybe we should do Owens and Balor in some sort of match, and then give, well, no, because Owens is going to have to fight Morrison at some point. I have an idea. Oh, well, has Balor actually beaten Owens, like, ever? I can't check the record because he just won last week, if I recall correctly. Yeah, he just won, but his record's not that great. We could put the title on the line just, like, for ratings' sake, and that way when Morrison gets the shot, I don't think it's that important. Do we go ahead and put Rhea Ripley and Shayna Baszler in the main event? I think maybe that's what we should do. We're gonna make it Extreme Rules, so these two women are gonna tear the house down in the main event. Because, I don't know, I feel like this would be a good main event. I know that they fought for the NXT title before, but I still feel like, I don't know, they just seem like they'd have chemistry. Like, they're two very physical superstars. We're giving a lot of people, like, a rest this week, which, I mean, but we mainly just wanna get the big, you know, the big rivalry on the show. We have lost too many weeks in a row, and we need to have a rivalry that is really bringing in the fans, so we're gonna go ahead, Rhea Ripley and Shayna Baszler in the main event. We'll give them next week off, and next week we'll try to put the emphasis maybe on Bayley and Ember Moon. We can figure that out as we go. Let's take a look at our advertising. We can do viral campaign, which is the best to get the optional goal, so I'm gonna go for that. Network quality lights and effects, we will go ahead and do that. Let's see. No need to purchase those yet. We'll go with Gorilla Crew. And yeah, the Capitol Wrestling Center is the best we can currently book at the moment. Looking at our power cards again, injury rehab, well, no one's injured, health spa 3, trains one of your emerging talent stars. I mean, do we want Jody Garcia to also be a permanent on the roster? I think right now, the current situation we have going on is that we have, I think, just too many people on our roster. I think there's too many contracts happening. So I think what we're going to do, we're probably going to run out Keith Lee's contract. Because honestly, I've booked him like garbage, and he deserves better. He can go to AEW and, you know, tear the house down there. When Mickey's contract expires, she's probably just going to go. And then potentially that could make way to bring in some more talent, but might not be necessary. So let's go ahead and confirm the book for this week. Starting off, we got tag team action. Tony Storm and Ember Moon versus the newly heel Asuka and Bayley, and they get the win. So Asuka and Bayley, that's a team that seemed to work. So a big win for them, big successful outing for Asuka. Promo is okay from Mickie James, but it does grow the rivalry, which is what we want. Keith Lee versus John Morrison. The win goes to John Morrison, so he's really building himself up for that title match. Good win there for John Morrison. Stone Cold Steve Austin with an excellent promo. Gets 5,000 new fans. And then main event, Extreme Rules, Rhea Ripley and Shayna Baszler. Does Rhea get her win back? Or does Shayna take it once again? And she does. 4-star match. But it didn't do anything to boost the rivalry, which is interesting. I don't know what to make of that. Okay, Tyler Breeze, Brock Lesnar for the title again, because what are stakes? Breeze wins again, gets 4 stars. This is the part that's just not fun. They can just book the same feuds over and over again, and they get good ratings. Like, they have superstars, they could mix up the classes and stuff, but they're not. They're just not. And this is probably going to be the blow-off match for this feud. It's not a good feud. None of them are good feuds. 3.5. There's no effect. So we lose again because this game hates us. We had a 4-star opener, or a 4-star main event. Still not good enough. I don't know what to do. I don't know how to win this game. Bayley and Asuka are an incredible tag team. Rhea Ripley and Shayna Baszler are both fantastic at Extreme Rules matches. Pair them up again in a repeat. Well, maybe. You know, that could definitely be the blow-off to their feud. You know, and I mean, like, Extreme Rules is the kind of match where you can have two very different Extreme Rules matches, even if it's, like, technically the same stipulation, but things can be a lot different each time. Bayley and Ember Moon had a rivalry going. I mean, well, if tag team matches would progress the rivalry, then you wouldn't... Ah! Whatever. Free special effects booking. Hey. Okay, so yeah, our fans did go up, but we are still in a bad spot. It's just, we're just stuck here. Like I said, it's purgatory. There's nothing we can do. Keith Lee, contract expiring at the end of the week. Be interested in staying? Well, we did renew his contract once. We got some more out of him, but like I said, he's kind of just, you know, haven't really booked him that great. I take the blame for that. Did you hear the crowd last week? We got our first tag team win. I knew Bayley and I would kill it. Small increase to Asuka's morale. I don't know if you knew this, but I love being in a certain match, the one and only tables. Nobody does that better than me. All right, so I guess we should have Mickey James and tables book you in one within the next 2 weeks. Yeah, we're gonna do that. I guess we're gonna go ahead and have Mickey James versus Peyton Royce in a tables match on our next show. That's what she wants. That's what we're gonna do. So let's go for it. Mickey James, Peyton Royce, which is also conveniently Peyton Royce's specialty. So that's interesting. Peyton Royce right now 3-3. So this could be a big opportunity for her to get a win. Mickey James, of course, had that loss to Tamina, so she's going to need to turn it around for her sake. Look at free agency again. The head of the table, Roman Reigns, the tribal chief. Do we pick him up? You know, I'm talking about, like, trying to make room for contracts and stuff, but I mean, like, it's the tribal chief. Maybe not. We could get Charlotte on a permanent contract. Some big-name stars here, but... Like I said, though, we are trying to shed some of our contracts, so that is, now is not the time. Now is not the time to make those plays. Let's go ahead, schedule a run-in on one of your champions this week. All right, so, yeah, so we're giving Mickey James that match. John Morrison did get the win. Now, just to clarify, this isn't a sort of thing where, like, if I did interference on, like, if I had Keith Lee come after John Morrison, that doesn't count. It has to be a run-in on the champ. Okay. So then we'll have Finn Balor go after Kevin Owens, basically just say, hey, you know, I'm here too, don't forget about me. But the main event, of course, for the title, Morrison and KO, that's gonna be big. Hopefully KO can retain despite the interference. Maybe Balor, you know, gets KO the win by DQ. We will find out in time. We're going to have Bayley call out Ember Moon because we want to get that rivalry to level 4 and give it an opportunity for a big payoff. And then we want to do another charity promo. Once again, we don't really have anything going on with Stone Cold this week, it would seem. You know, obviously the plan was that I was going to want to put him in a rivalry with Kevin Owens because I think that's just kind of like the classes match up. You know, maybe we should turn him heel. Like, Austin coming in, betraying Kevin Owens. Because otherwise, it's like, we wanna use the legend to put over one of our main roster guys. So, you know, if we had Owens turn heel, it's a bit weird. What's Morrison's record? 5-3? But yeah, Steve Austin, we could also, you know, just have him in some kind of match. Maybe we should do that, actually. So we have the opener, we have the call out. We could do another tag team match. Here we go. Get a legendary tag team of Jeff Hardy, not Triton. Get out of here, Triton. Of Jeff Hardy and Stone Cold Steve Austin teaming up. We'll put him up against... Should I put him up against Triton? No, we only have one heel, actually. So, yeah, maybe turning Austin heel would be a good thing. But right now, probably not. Maybe it's a little too soon. Here's what we'll do. Well, if I have him fight Murphy, they'll probably drop into a rivalry, which is not what I want. And I also have other people that I want to get on the show. Like, Bianca hasn't had a match recently. So let's do... Should it be Jody Garcia? I know that that's not going to be good for the ratings, but it's in the mid-card, so it should be okay. We'll have Jody go one-on-one with Bianca because we want... Well, either that or we could do a tag team. Get the team of Jody and Tamina back together. Two giants. Make it Bianca and... There's nobody who is just freely available who hasn't competed lately. Yeah, let's just do Bianca and... Should it be Tamina rather than Jody, maybe? Tamina trying to continue her winning streak. Bianca as well trying to continue a winning streak. Try to go for the title. We'll try that, I guess. Trying to think then, what would we do for our last promo? We, again, just have to keep doing charity promos because otherwise we have no shot at catching them in the fans. Yeah, and Bianca hasn't wrestled in a match in a while. This is why we're trying to get contracts off the show. Let's have Keith Lee do one last thing for the brand before we send him out. Maybe that's not actually necessary. Maybe it is better to keep superstars on the show. Let's have it be instead, I don't know, Rhea Ripley. She'll go ahead and do the charity work. Let's go into the things. So we want the Capitol Wrestling Center. We want our Gorilla Crew. Veteran Lights, 3D Effects, and Pyro, because we got Mickie James. She's got the 5-star power. So we are good. We're going to do superstar signings. So just invest everything. Invest in all the things. Yeah, we don't need to buy any more crew yet. Whoop, don't confirm it just quite yet. Power cards, we could do free special effects. Because I think that's the one where we're really putting in the money. So I think I will go ahead and use the free special effects card to make sure that we can have free pyro and whatnot. Save us 35,000. And the other card that we have, I think, was free advertising, which 35,000 as well. But we could potentially be getting to the point where we have the commercial campaign available. So maybe I will save that card yet. Maybe not use them both on the same show. Anyway, let's go ahead and confirm the book once again. I think that makes 3 weeks of SmackDown in this episode. So we have a tables match, Mickie James and Peyton Royce. The victory goes to Mickie James. And I'm sure Peyton Royce will not be happy about that. The rivalry doesn't progress, which is unfortunate. Bayley and Ember Moon gets the rivalry to level 4. Tamina and Bianca Belair in the mid card. The victory goes to Tamina, which is not exactly what I was looking for. Only a 1-star match. Oof. That's rough. Rhea Ripley gets us the charity promo, gets us the fans. Finn Balor interfering in the title match. Now, is this going to take the title from Owens, or is it going to end via disqualification? It is time to find out. The winner is John Morrison, but does he get the title? Only a 3-star match, so maybe not. The rivalry between Balor and Owens grows. We'll find out what happened with the title. I am just not interested in this rivalry between there's nothing to say. I'm not even going to cover the Raw shows at this point because, there's nothing to say every time. Every time they get, a 5-star, they get, 7 stars on each show, and we are just, there's nothing we can do. There's just nothing. We should just be booking the same programs all the time, and we would win. We would do better, actually. 4 stars. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I will just stop showing the Raw. Doesn't matter what their cards are. We'll just need to know that they got 1 billion stars and beat us. But our show, we booked it well. It was good booking. The mid card was the lowest part. Yeah, we're gonna have to. I don't know. Like, I don't know. I don't know what to do at this point to make things better. Especially when, like, the rivalries don't progress. Oops, I meant to look at the match report. I guess we'll just see whether or not Morrison is actually the champ now. Mickie James is perfect for tables matches. Well, I mean, yeah, she said that. She said as much. Tamina and Bianca are great superstars. Their classes just don't work together. Never seen John Morrison so dominant before. Is it just a lucky streak? Like what Rhea Ripley did in that promo. SmackDown must really like Morrison. Mickie James is such a pathetic cheater. Peyton Roy saying that she lost unfairly. Mickie James just like, nope, I'm just better than you. And you know it. It really does feel like the only fans that we're gaining in this challenge is just whatever we do for charity work. But it looks like Morrison did take the title from Owens, which is... That was not at all what I was looking for, but it is what it is, you know? It's GM. It's my GM. Things are unpredictable. Mickie James' contract is up at the end of the week. How are we going to handle that situation? Find out in the next episode. See you then.